Coming to the stage, we got my good friend. He's on the Bardstown podcast. Also, he's one of the funniest guys out here in the city. Y'all make some noise for Sean Smith.
Sean, I'm happy to be here. Thank you guys for letting me tell jokes. I am the product of two parents who've been married for like 50 plus years. They've been together, been great. Two brothers, two sisters, great family. Just great. It's a great life for everything but comedy. Because there's nothing to talk about. You know, everybody has like the story of like struggle and like out of hard stuff. Like, life was all right. I don't know what to tell you. Even growing up, I remember this. I remember my dad. I have a great relationship with my dad, but I used to be real self-conscious about it because all of my friends had a horrible relationship with their dad. Didn't know their dad, whatever it was. So I'd talk to him and I'd be like, hey man, what's going on? He's like, shh, man, I ain't never met my dad. I'm like, oh, for real? The other one was like, yeah man, my dad's in jail. Like, dang. Like, what about you, Sean? I'm like, oh, my dad left this morning. I'm like, damn! I'm like, yeah, but he'll be back after work. Like, my comedy can't even be the same as other comedians. Like, you see a lot of comedians come up and talk about the struggle. They talk about, you know, the food that they had to eat and all the stuff that they did to get beat by their grandmas with tire irons and stuff. You know what I'm saying? Like, I didn't have that life. But I would look funny if I tried to do jokes like other comedians. Like, if I came up here and was like, hey, y'all remember being middle class? Y'all remember that shit? Going to the grocery store and having to get the cereal at eye level. Y'all remember that? Eye level cereal, y'all remember that? Golden Grahams, Basic Four, y'all talking about? Y'all remember when you used to get in trouble in school and your uncle would come over and beat you in NBA Live 95 and then ask you about your debt? Just like how things were going. You cared about you as an individual. Oh shit, we got a white woman, y'all. Y'all know what she thinking. Y'all know what she thinking. She look at me and she's like, weren't you in my advanced class? Y'all got an Apple Watch? Y'all in here? I just got an Apple Watch. You got one? I remember when the future was something really cool and like not, like someone calling you on your watch seemed like it was a really cool thing that would happen in the future. And that's just an inconvenience when you're just looking at your wrist yelling, shit! I'm gonna call you back! Like, I miss those days when the future was something exciting and you could look forward to it. But what I'm saying is, I hate that I just found out that when a bomb is coming, they just send you a text to let you know. This is the scariest thing. Don't just surprise me with a bomb every time. That should be the surprise. Don't warn me a bomb. A bomb is coming, seek immediate shelter. Where do you go for a bomb? What? People were hiding in bathtubs. Is anybody seek a bomb? That is terrifying. I don't ever want to find out, like, if it came in like one of those Amber Alert things, and your phone just buzzes like, pss, pss, pss. I would look down and be like, who would name their daughter Bomb? That is a crazy bird. I don't know. It's scary, man. I want my future that Marty McFly promised me. I want flying cars. I don't want cars falling out of the sky and blowing up. Getting a text about it. It just seems like a bad thing. Been dating my girlfriend for 2 years. But yeah, it's cool. It's cool. This is the time where we start talking about our dreams, right? And I tell her about like all my hopes and dreams of being a comedian. And she literally just wakes up and talks about her dream that she had every single night in detail as if it was a real thing. And I have to listen to it because if I don't, I get in trouble, right? So it's weird because she'll sit there and she'll be like, so I was walking through the store and I saw this guy that looked like he would say library instead of library. And then, are you not paying attention to me? Are you serious? I have to pay attention to this thing that never happened. It would be cool if it was like a premonition dream, where she's dreaming of something like, I think the president's gonna get assassinated today. I don't listen to all of that. I don't want to listen to her talk about the time she walked into KFC and ordered something in a dream. Like, this is not, my time could be spent doing anything else. Comedy takes you a lot of cool places. This is one of the cooler places. I went to Lagodi, Indiana, which is not a cool place. Anybody here been to Lagodi, Indiana before? So literally what you've seen and heard is the population of Lagodi, Indiana. Like two people. I went there for a post-prom party. I was the reason kids weren't having sex, and they did not like me, right? Because you know, after prom is what you do. So I was trying to tell jokes to them, and I couldn't identify with them. Here's the thing, if you don't know this, you go, as a comedian, you go to town, you have to do research about the town to find out what's going on in the town. I went to Lagodi, Indiana, so I did some research. I found out that they are 0.02% black, right? 98.98% white, and 0.2% Native American. And it's the only time I've ever been outnumbered by Native Americans. I didn't know what that meant. I didn't know if like that meant that they had like the projects were just run down teepees. I was like a whole bunch of different like drive-bys and arrows. I don't know. So I went there and I'm trying to connect to them. So I'm at a loss already. I stand up there, I happen to be black, they've never seen that before, so they might as well think I'm Bigfoot, I'm saying. I try to connect with them, right? And so I was writing on a joke about dating apps. And it's like a dating app, everybody has a dating app. You got JDate for Jewish people. You've got FarmersOnly.com for people who want to find someone else that smells like shit all the time. ChristianMingle.com for desperate people. Because if somebody is just like, God, I just wish I could find somebody. There's some type of building that would house Christians I could mingle with. Some type of facility I could go to meet other Christians. Give up the internet. Then I got blackpeopleeat.com for white women. So we have everybody has one. So I'm telling this joke, right? And I just get blank faced. Nobody, like everybody's just staring at me. And I realize that they don't need day lamps, right? They don't need them. And what came out of my mouth was, oh, y'all don't need dating apps. You just need a real good family reunion. Lagodi, Indiana was not happy with that. Prom King in the front row with the Velcro shoes on, he it was like, we in Kentucky! Alright, fair game, right? So I asked him, what about the next town over? Next secret in comedy, every city you go to hates the next town over. Doesn't matter where you go, they hate it, right? So I figured I'd get something good from that. What's supposed to do with the next town over? One of the kids said, next town over? They're a bunch of dad paws! What is a dad paw, right? I was like, what? I'm sorry, what is a dad paw? And the kid was like, a dad paw is when your grandpa is also your dad. Never knew, didn't know. Had no idea that was a thing, but it opened up. so many different options, right? Your family tree can be a reef. It just no branches, just kind of decorative. Got sis moms and uncles. That's embalming, right? It's not working, so I'm trying to connect with them. I asked them, like, okay, what's unique about your town, right? What's going on here? They're like, oh, we got the Amish. I thought, that's cool. Amish is cool. And he was like, yeah, but they're on meth. How? How Amish don't use electricity, how are they cooking it? I had a lot of questions. What does that look like? And I've been to a lot of different places like Amish communities or Shaker Village, you know, where they're making butter or candles or whatever it is, and they tour. It's very nice. I was trying to imagine what that place would be like on meth. What does that look like, right? And I imagine you walk in and dude is like, hi. My name's Jebediah, and welcome to the Amish community. Here's my brother Jed, and he is making the butter. And Jed's like,
thank you, God! Thank you, God!
That'd be a fun place to go. But I don't quit my day job, right? My day job is I work in elementary schools. It is an interesting job. You know, there's a lot of really good, decent people out there who are trying to figure out if it's worth it to bring a kid into this world. Because it's so tough. There's a lot going on. You got potential bomb threats sent by text message. It's just a scary world that we have, and some good, decent people are trying to figure out, like, is it worth it? Is this the time to bring a kid in? And meanwhile, dumb people are just fucking, and they are bringing so many kids into this world, and there's so many more of them than there are of us. And I just feel like we need to balance the power out. Like, we're out of balance right now, and I think that we need to have, like, a crusade for children, but, like, a real crusade for children. Like, not what they do just to hold stuff out of stoplights. I'm talking about, like, you can call it something different, like poking with a purpose. And you can have more good, decent people having more sex with less condoms. Because what I'm saying is, that kid in your class that ate glue, there's six of them now. And that's just what they do at 2:30. Like, that's after recess, eat glue. You learn a lot by calling parents. You get phone calls. I have to make phone calls. So I find out that the apple doesn't fall very far from the tree a lot of times. Here's how it goes, right? So you call a parent whose kids might be bad and have a lot of trouble in school. A lot of times the answer machine that you get is like a gospel song or something to deal with the kid. So you call and be like, never would have made it without you. Hi, this is Miss Bessie. Leave a message. Yes, Miss Bessie, your son Diablo was having trouble at school. Diablo, and we don't have anything to deal with Spanish Satan, so if you sometimes you get sexy answer machine messages from people, that's weird too. You probably have a friend who has something just like a standard message that's way too sexy for just everyday life. It's weird when in education you're calling for that. So I'll call and be like, this is the Reeks. I'm unavailable. Leave a message. I'm being entertained. Reese, your son has ringworm. How are you probably pick them up, just use the same cream you got at home. Probably at you do this, I'll get off. This is a quick impression. This is an impression of a bad parent's ringtone. So when I'm calling a parent that's not a good parent, this is the ringtone that I get 99% of the time.
the Cricket Wireless number you're trying to reach. That's what
you're trying to do.
Thank you.